Sunday School Christmas program. Is it good to be in the church today? I have just a few announcements for you this morning. Actually, just one. On Wednesday, at 5:30, our youth are going caroling. But this is not just an invitation for our youth, this is an invitation for everybody. We invite you all to come and join us as we go caroling for people who cannot make it to church. And we bring them the joy of Christmas this season. Our radio broadcast from this morning is in memory of Iola Kostad, from Irvin and Janice Kostad and family. The bulletins are in memory of Marjorie Bain and from her family. And the cross wreath is in memory of Troy Ellison and Tammy Schulenberg, given by their family. Before we begin our program today, I'd like to invite Dean Solom to come forward and give us a little temple talk this morning.
Good morning. Okay, my name is Dean Solom. Is this on?
No. No. Is it plugged in?
What now?
All right. I have a message to share on behalf of the stewardship committee this morning. So as we enter worship today, it's easy to take for granted that the sanctuary is here, with beautiful stained glass windows, carpet, wood floors, pews, the sound system, and heat. The list goes on and on. The offering trays, hymn notes, the piano, the organ. Bulletins to guide us through our worship today. And oh yes, let's not forget about our pastors. All these things are made possible through a century of faithful giving by the people of this congregation. This building has allowed us to serve our members and our neighbors for 100 years. Our predecessors' legacy of faith and commitment to build this church has been a gift to us. At our recent fall meeting, the congregation approved a renovation project for the narthex and Grace Fellowship Hall. The project will include new flooring in the narthex, the entryway, Grace Hall, the kitchen, the bathrooms, and the third floor Sunday School gathering area. We are establishing a Century Fund to receive gifts for this renovation project. Please make a donation of $10, $100, or maybe $1,000 in celebration of 100 years. Please make gifts in memory of or in honor of someone special celebrating our heritage as a congregation. We sit here today because of the faithfulness and generosity of those who came before us. How will we provide for those who come after us? Included in your bulletin, you'll find a red sheet of paper. That is the Century Fund Pledge Form. So thank you for your time this morning, and I wish you all a merry Christmas.
Thank you, Dean. As Dean mentioned, we are starting a new renovation project. And I wanted to just remind you, for those of you who maybe have not heard, that today we are also celebrating Heritage Sunday. Today we celebrate this building, this space that we are in right now, because it is 100 years old. And so this is a great mile marker for the life of our congregation. At this time, I'd like to invite Mike and Irene and Yusike and their family to come forward for the lighting of our Advent candle.
Thank you. We light this candle in the name of the one who out of sorrow and pain has brought us joy. May the flame that now burns burn lightly to bring light, warmth, and joy to all people. Let joyful every yearning heart is hope to the coming of God's kingdom.
We praise you, O God, for this victory that marks our days of preparation for Christ's advent. As we light the candles of this truth, strengthen our hearts as we await the Lord's coming in glory. Enlighten us with your grace, that we may serve our neighbors in need. Grant peace through Christ our Lord, whose time is certain and whose day draws near.
Thank you. be with child and give birth to a son, and you will call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High.
How will this be, since I am your virgin?
Oh, I know this one. Shh, the angel's going to tell her.
The Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God.
That's not really hopeless and hard class.
I told you, shh, the angel's still speaking. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a baby at her old age, for nothing is impossible with God.
It's amazing what they can do in those 1,000 months.
This took place over 2,000 years ago.
Who is this Elizabeth anyways?
Then the angel left. Wait.
I am the Lord's servant, may be as you have said.
Then the angel left her.
And then Mary got ready and hurried to a town in the hill country of Judah to see her relative, Elizabeth.
Hey, where is she going? Who is this Elizabeth?
Elizabeth was Mary's older cousin who lived in another town. She had been married to a good man named Zechariah for many, many years.
Strange, doesn't look that old.
Months earlier, she had visited Elizabeth's husband, Zechariah. The angel had visited Elizabeth's husband, Zechariah, when he had come to offer a sacrifice at the temple.
What's a temple?
Like a church, but for Jesus.
Oh.
The angel said.
Hey, is that the same angel?
Yes, it is. See, it was the same angel. We like to try to stay as close as reality as we can.
Oh, I see. I can see the angel here. It's not like the real thing.
The angel said to Zechariah,
"Don't be afraid, Zechariah.
You angels, they're saying say that a lot.
Actually, angels are quite impulsive creatures. You can look them up in various paragraphs in the Bible, where angelic appearances are recorded. Almost all of them reflect how frightening the person sees them.
Are you all right?
Anyway, they ended up having to say things every time.
Say what?
Don't be afraid.
Zechariah, your prayer said the prayer. Your wife Elizabeth will bear you a son, and you are to give him the name John. He will be a joy and delight to you, and many will rejoice because of his birth. For he will be great in the sight of the Lord, and he will help to make ready the people prepared for the Lord.
How can I be sure of this? I am an old man, and my wife is well along in years.
Did you hear what he said? He called his wife old. Boy, is he in trouble.
Oh, he does something worse. He questioned an angel. Watch this.
I am Gabriel. I stand in the presence of God, and I have been sent to speak to you and tell you this good news. And now you will be silent and not able to speak until the day is come, because you did not believe my word, which will come true at the proper time. But
thank you. redeemed his people. And you, my child, will be called a prophet of the Most High, for you will go on before the Lord to prepare the way for him, to give his people the knowledge of salvation through the forgiveness of their sins because of their tender mercy of our God.
Well, all that time in silence must have given him time to think about what he said.
And John grew up and became a great man of God, just like the angel had said. And later he would be known as John the Baptist.
He was a Baptist?
Let's not get into that right now.
Do you believe that?
Well, let's sing some music.
Will Mary be dead?
Oh, I'm sure she will.
son, an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and they were really scared. Don't tell me. Oh, no.
Don't be afraid. I bring you good news of a great joy that will be for all people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloth, lying in a manger. Glory to God in the highest, and every peace to men, on whom His favor rests.
Thank you. story.
Hey, hold it. What happens next?
Oh, you don't want to know.
Yes, I do. What happened to Mary? What happened to the baby? How am I supposed to believe in Christmas if I don't know what happened?
Are you sure you want to know what happened?
Yes.
Be careful. Wanting to know is the first step to believing.
All right, I want to know. Tell me.
Well, okay. We'll read it together. You suck.
Well, almost. Later, Joseph was
upstairs. We invite you to come and join us for that. Special thank you to everyone who was a part of putting together this Christmas program. Thank you to Tammy Cruz, Bobby Joe Spencer, Taylor Luce, Tiana Cruz, Chris Lee, Deb Lewis. Thank you for Teresa and Tiana for running the sound booth back there. Thank you. I mean, there's so many people that we can thank. Thank you for all the volunteers who came to help with costumes and music, giving snacks to the kids. That was really important. And thank you to you guys. You guys did a great job. Thank you for bringing us that wonderful Christmas word today. I think we have a lot of future pastors in our congregation. So thank you to all of you guys. Thank you for all your help. Go in peace. Serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Next year? Or is it 2 years?